dedicate this video to everyone who has it extra hard in life. I see you. I'm not perfect. The patron of Necken sees you. All my Christians and all good people everywhere. The way fighting is done in America pits the people who would naturally prevail, or perhaps have a natural tendency to prevail, against those who would prevail if it was only a brute force fight, a fight of clubs. For instance, the evolution of the club itself from a big Captain Caveman club to a little stick with a heavy end, to finally a stick as you see in Taekwondo and on the drums, etc. And sticks covered in leaves as you see in the book Fighting for Honor, how the Angolans used to spar. I'm sure the Igbos as well. Chapter 1, Chapter 2. So when you truly understand what's going on here, yes, it's the evolution of brain over bronze, of mind over matter, of wit over strength. That is why strength isn't at the beginning. It is technique, then timing, and then force. Strength is only represented when it is coupled with acceleration, as opposed to the wrestler who would prevail naturally if it is a match of throwing a few punches and taking someone to the ground. And I do not think it's a coincidence that the older athlete tends to be a heavier, less stamina having person. You know, when you think about it, what are your coaches, right? They're these football coaches, these bigger guys, you know, football. Even a lot of these basketball coaches, they're not these tall, skinny, athletic guys. They're these bigger guys, typically, especially in a lot of these white suburbs in America. I'm just trying to put things into perspective. I'm not racist, but when you put things into perspective, you can tell that this is a Babylonian system, we'll call it, out of respect for my Italian brothers and other brothers, but it's really a Greco-Roman wrestling system, which gives the Greco-Roman body and person with a culture, the nature and nurture and their history therein of Greece and Rome. Those who are athletes in that regard, the upper hand, as opposed to the more convicted, courageous, audacious, oppressed minority who tends to be more Igbo in shape, or perhaps railroaded because of their Asian shape, etc. And the answer isn't to tell a nation that is disproportionately overweight to eat more and to put on more weight. We're dying of diabetes and of diseases related to being overweight as it is, and illnesses and afflictions. So unless you want to pass away, you might want to let the Holy Spirit pass through you and remain in you and around you. Do not reject the Holy Spirit. Be true. Be a true African. Do not choose one region of the world over the other. Choose the motherland and the planet as a whole, as one. A lot of you struggle with these concepts, and I don't blame you. We live in a very confusing time where cowards who think like the Riddler or the Joker seek to fuck you over like the Violator from Spawn. And understand, I, Chukwu Emeka, am a man of honor. I don't want to lie to anyone, and I don't lie to anyone. I tell you the truth, even though it gets me to the psych ward and mental hospitals. And some of you might think that's funny, or that that by itself discredits me. I disagree. I think we live in a time where great men are very likely to be treated like the Ghostbusters, or worse, by some Walter Peck motherfuckers, or worse. One must do their due diligence and stay on top of the game and plan ahead. Don't let the demons plan for you. They love to plan your life and everyone else's, so they can tell who to fuck who to pay who, and who to pay homage to what, who, what, where, when, how, why. The WH loves to control that. Again, I'm not racist, and the Lord thy God demands that his children are not racist. We must be true to who we are, and we are all true Africans who have just spread out over time. How can we lay claim to this land or that land when we all started from the same land? And and ventured out. The only way it makes sense is if you can say that my family has been here for a long time and you have some sort of a sacred or religious claim to it. And then you have to be very careful not to trod, you know, not to step on others, as you see with the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. One must fight for honor with scripture, with wisdom. And I know it's not easy. My people fought a propaganda war while they were being slaughtered. Just Google the Nigerian Civil War or look it up on YouTube search. A lot of good people died praying to God, fighting with scripture, fighting from the heart, appealing to the heart. A lot of good people, Swedish, Swiss people were shot at delivering aid to Biafra. And there's many other white peoples there as well. Now, it wasn't a huge movement, but you know, they did what they could, the Red Cross and them, and we are grateful. But then there are those troublemakers who rejoice every time Igbo or Judah suffers. They smile when Christians come upon hard times. When we shed tears, they pop bottles of champagne. And they wetten their lips with champagne while we wetten our cheeks with tears. Isn't that fucked up? Oh, how it tastes. Indeed. He who lives by the sword dies by the sword. A spear is not a sword, and life is not a game. One must understand the various forms of things. The hawk, the falcon, the eagle, and who should be on whose side. America was meant to be on my side. Birds of a feather, different forms of the spirit, symbolized by different creatures. Not the detestable, unclean. Read your Bible. They call them detestable and unclean birds, right? Because there's a difference. The pro and the con. The devil tries to take over everything, but he doesn't succeed. But he gets so far. And he's limited by perhaps sacred numbers, such as 6. Perhaps they're the limit. And you know them by their works, because the devil wants to push the limit. So his works are going to have something to do with the limit. Unless, of course, he's trying to deceive so he can pull a fast one on you. That's why you got to move at God's speed and don't let the devil slow you down. Take great strides spiritually, even if you are small physically. The hare, the hawk, the leopard, the different forms, and with the heart, the four, they're like a square with a side tip and turned around. And it's rolling until it turns into a wheel. And now we're moving, brother. Mind, body, heart, and soul, 4 together. And now we're moving, brother, as a wheel, making progress. The different forms of the light temple, the different forms of the angles of light, the different forms of the light temple creatures, the different martial arts, katas, divine war art forms. Art forms. Brothers, I'm not playing with these motherfuckers one bit. I really have trained for a long, long time for this. I'm not about to just pull somebody out of the back room or something and beat them down in front of camera or something. I'm talking about the scripture, the psalm. That's why I train with weapons that aren't likely to drop blood. And on camera, I, along with my viewers, have witnessed what happens firsthand. My left hand and my with the heart, one could argue. First hand spiritually, right hand physically. When I was cut with a hunting knife during a demonstration for my viewers. Cost me a pretty penny for my deductible, you know. But it's okay, it's for the people. The world will remember my story, my battles, my scars. I love you all. Proceed in the name of God. I'm not perfect. I'll probably be mad at you in the near future. But we must proceed.